All right, everyone, welcome to this weekend's Sidereal Astrology Forecast. This is for June 2nd through the 4th of 2017. All right, so a lot going on this weekend. We do have the moon in Virgo all weekend. Moon in Virgo is feeling perhaps a bit self-disciplined, maybe a bit perfectionistic. Usually when the moon's here, we're feeling a little bit more improvement-oriented, detail-oriented, and it does make it good for those types of things, you know, whether it's your work, your daily activities, whatever does require that sort of refinement of things, which is Virgo. Now, a lot going on because we do have, we've got Venus going over Uranus. We've got Mars squaring up to Chiron. We have the Sun trining up to Jupiter and squaring Neptune. So lots to talk about, but I would say generally this weekend, you know, on Friday, maybe some healing. Mars will be squaring up to Chiron. If there's any actions you can take that you feel, if you did take, you would heal. You know, there might be some wounds about some things that you may want to initiate, and through the initiation of it or of them, you can feel healed in the process. So that's going on Friday. Then as we go into Saturday, which is really the bulk of the aspects, Venus goes over Uranus. Maybe something new, different, unexpected, maybe with the things we enjoy in life and with relationships as well with that, which is quite nice. Then also the Sun's going to be trining up to Jupiter, so we could be quite optimistic, hopeful, inspired on Saturday. But then as we get into Sunday, that Sun starts to square up to Neptune, maybe leaving a little bit of a haze or uncertainty. So finding healthy ways of relaxing and getting into ourselves spiritually, I think will be emphasized. All right, so that's the weekend generally, but let's go and look at this in more detail when we return. All right, so here is the moon Virgo. We'll be here all weekend long. Virgo, very large constellation, having to do with essentially finding solutions, right? Virgo's all about organizing things in our life, detailing things, and all in all, just wanting a bit of that, you know, wanting a bit of organization, improvement. Could be very perfectionistic with this, but finding healthy ways of improving what we do have control over. And of course, with Pisces opposite Virgo, letting go of everything we don't have control over. But Virgo, certainly everything that has to do with your own personal growth, personal self-improvement, as well as your environment can go well, you know, improving things on that level. So that's the moon's placement. And of course, you know, this is all about Taurus at the moment. We do have some sign changes actually this weekend. Mars is going to slowly shift into Gemini. Mercury's coming into Taurus. So yeah, with Taurus, the whole lunar cycle is about developing our resourceful side, our steady side, our grounded side with this, and taking things slow and steadily. You know, that's essentially what Taurus is all about. Cultivating our resources, enjoying things in life, having gratitude, all of this. Now, Mercury shifting into here means our mind is starting to maybe be more stabilized. Because we've had Mercury in Aries, which is very fiery. Maybe we've been very direct with our communications, which I think we will still be with Mars and Gemini, which I'll talk about. But yeah, there's been a lot of fire behind our minds, maybe active, maybe communication-wise, and maybe with the routine, just a lot of this you know, active energy perhaps for some of us, or just more fire behind it, or whatever it might be. So it is stabilizing with that. You know, our minds, our communication, and quite possibly our routine as well, becoming more grounded, more stable. And that's just how our mind is, you know, wanting to understand something first before moving on to the next thing. Really making sure we got a grip on something with, you know, with that Taurus energy, making sure we understand it, it's stable, it's grounded before we move on to the next. So we could be thinking that way, communicating this way. And again, the routine could be emphasizing that. Now, speaking of this Mars going into Gemini, this is, you know, all about the same sort of things as Mercury, right? So communication and, you know, sharing and exchanging and learning. And so Mars coming in here can give us, as we go into probably mostly next week, a bit of, wanting and motivated towards understanding things, right? Learning about things, very inquisitive, wanting to understand things and maybe even, again, communicate and share information or just share with others in general. So that's where the motivation is. that's where the drive is. And that could be how we're getting things done as well. All right, so when we are going after the things we want, we are taking action, maybe wanting to really get into the understanding of it, you know, figure it out, and then very motivated to do the same. And it's kind of interesting. Mercury, the ruler of Gemini, is leaving a fire sign. In fact, it's Mars's sign. So this is leaving the fire with the communication, but this is entering fire with the communication. There's a sort of swap here taking place where I still do think things involving the mind and communication do have this, now with Mars, initiation, drive, intentfulness, and you could say fire. All right, so that's the sign changes, all in the context of a much larger picture there. But this weekend, as you can see, a lot going on astrologically. We're going to talk about the most important aspects here. So on Friday, Mars squaring up to Chiron. There could be some wounds coming up on Friday, quite possibly. Maybe having to do with confidence, the things you want to take action towards, but you feel maybe wounded to take action with. Now, the awesome thing about Chiron is that, especially in a square like this, is that if we initiate, if we go into what we feel wounded about, or doubtful, or insecure, or whatever it is, you know, psychological trauma, you know, deep things like this, but we feel wounded about it, and we take action towards it, the process itself is healing. So if there is anything today, I would ask you, not ask yourself, what can you do to take action towards anything that you feel wounded about? And it's through that initiation with the square that I think is getting on the right side of this transit. And in that way, you're doing the healing willfully, willingly, and that facilitates the whole process. But I think it's going to happen anyways. I think as we get into Saturday, certainly more of this feeling a bit rejuvenated, healed, you know, when it comes to the things we want, comes to our confidence, motivation, drive, all of this Mars energy. All right, so let's talk about Saturday, because a lot going on Saturday. Venus over Uranus, probably the most significant. This is about new and unexpected stuff with the things we enjoy in life and also relationships. Okay, so depending on how that, you know, works for you, maybe a little bit of both. So I think it's great with this conjunction to just be open to new and different things. It's in Pisces. So again, anything that is about just kind of going with the flow, right? Letting go, Pisces, letting go, and finding the freedom of that, all right? Finding the freedom of that. And that can be very enjoyable. In fact, we've learned a lot about this over the past 3, I think maybe even 4 months now with Venus, with her transit of Pisces and retrograde and all of that earlier in the year. So there's been a lot of energy in Pisces with Venus for us to understand about how to connect to life in this more receptive way. And with Uranus, Uranus has been showing us this for many years. So this has been showing us that we can have freedom by letting go, by surrendering, by going with the flow. So I think that's the context of it, but anything you can do to free yourself up, try something new and different, exciting with the things you enjoy in life, with relationships perhaps, can certainly start a new beginning here. And it's fundamentally about freedom, really. So freedom. Maybe it's freedom in relationships, you know, the importance of that, and free-spiritedness, individualism, mixing things up, being open to new and different things. That's all Uranus. So new beginnings with that collectively, and at the same time, the Sun is going to be trining up to Jupiter and squaring up to Neptune. One thing I do want to say, though, about the values and relationships, the Venus stuff. Venus is going to be trining the North Node at the same time. So with whatever this shift is or whatever we're feeling here with that sort of spark of excitement or something new, it is supporting the life path, okay? Trining up to the North Node does suggest that we've been learning a lot about what excites us, right? What it is we're interested in, and learning more about our own personal self-expression. So I think the more you're willing to, I don't know, learn about your self-expression, you could say, again, try new things in terms of what you enjoy, what you're interested in. For some of you, maybe it's more creative in nature with Leo. But whatever, you know, whatever it is that sparks that inner flame, I think is great to learn about and just sort of cultivate. And I think you'll find that very supportive to the life path. All right, so talking about this Sun trining up to Jupiter, squaring up to Neptune, these aspects here, Saturday going into Sunday. Moon still in Virgo, so we're still feeling that grounded reserve energy, detail-oriented, but inspired nonetheless. Sun trine Jupiter could be quite hopeful, optimistic, inspired, seeing the big picture, right? Can give us a bit of buoyancy there. And you know, the sun is self-expression. Trining Jupiter can really expand the sun energy. So expressing ourselves, yeah, having a bit of fun, creative energy, all of that is sort of being expounded upon, you know, expanded upon when Jupiter contacts the sun like that. But with that being said, and I think we're going to feel this mostly on Sunday, is that there might be some things that we want to or maybe need to do a little bit more healthfully when it comes to wanting to let go, surrender, and get rest, right? Because the sun square Neptune can give us a bit of a fogginess or a haze or sometimes a low energy, because you've got the sun, which is fire, and you've got Neptune, which is water, and the water puts out the fire, or maybe a little bit doubtful or confused. So whatever this cloudy or watery and even feeling a bit lost perhaps energy is that's surfacing on Sunday collectively, I think being aware of what you know, if there's any patterns of escaping that might be unhealthy in your life, that now on Sunday you can find some healthy ways of getting the rest that we want, because this is saying there's two aspects of ourself that want, you know, that we got part of ourself that just wants to express herself, but there's a part of ourself that wants to rest, wants to find peace. And so finding healthy ways of doing that, or maybe initiating, maybe with the square actually taking the initiative to get some rest, spirituality, you know, spiritual time, meditative time, yoga, prayer, you know, any type of spiritual activities that you can take, you can initiate, I think are fantastic. Or again, maybe just getting the rest you need in healthy ways. And then that's going to help subside whatever the more of the escaping or the illusions or whatever that dreamy but also confusing energy is of Neptune there. All right, so a lot going on. Hopefully I've broken that down for you simply. But as a recap, this whole weekend is about Virgo, fundamentally. I think it's great to see how we can improve, work on ourselves, right, through self-improvements, whether it's through your diet, your regimens, whatever it might be there. And, you know, that's essentially what Virgo is all about, is focusing on what we do have control over, which is ourselves, how we respond to things, how we live our life. Okay. Within that context, Friday could be a healing day. If there's anything that you do feel wounded towards, great to initiate that. You can find that very rejuvenating, as a result. And then on Saturday, there's a bit of this newness, different, something different, unexpected maybe, with enjoying life, with relationships, which can be starting a new beginning, about having freedom, freedom of going with the flow, of letting go, and feeling inspired at the same time, hopeful, optimistic, seeing the big picture, really good for philosophy, going for walks, just having that top-down perspective of life and being optimistic about it, which is Jupiter, which essentially means we're seeing the whole picture. Because when we are looking from the top down, we are optimistic. We're not narrowed into, you know, just this small little sphere of our life or whatever it is. We're seeing all the possibilities. We're seeing all the potentials. And it's a great day for that. A great weekend for that, actually. But then as we get into Sunday, yeah, maybe some confusion, uncertainty, something like that. And I think finding healthy ways of finding peace, rest, acceptance in our life can be fantastic. So I hope you all have a fantastic weekend. This will be the last daily, as I said in the last video. So, you know, I'll still be making the major videos. So I'll have the full moon report coming up next this week. And there's also the planner down in the comment section. If you haven't yet downloaded that, it's absolutely free for those of you who have been following my dailies. But have a great weekend. I'll see you next week for the full moon report. And do stay tuned for the weekly forecast as well. All right. Have a good one. See you next time.